Listening Library presents Ordinary People Change the World.
I am Sonia Sotomayor.
By Brad Meltzer. Illustrated by Christopher Eliopoulos. Read for you by Rebecca Soler and an ensemble cast.
I am Sonia Sotomayor. In Spanish, that's Yo soy Sonia Sotomayor. I was born in New York City, and my family came from Puerto Rico. I learned to speak Spanish before I spoke English. My family called me ají, which means hot pepper, because I was always jumping around and finding trouble. My mother used to say,
she learned to walk at 7 months and ran the very same day.
Even when my mother or my abuelita, my grandmother, dressed me up, my clothes would get wrinkled. Ribbons never stayed in my hair.
You're already a mess. What should we do with her?
There's nothing wrong with her, just too much energy.
One time, I got my head stuck in a bucket while I was trying to hear what my voice sounded like inside.
Oh, Sonia, what have you done now?
Hello in there! I also loved making up games, jousting like a knight with my little brother on my back. Charge!
Sonia, what have you done now?
One of my favorite places was my abuelita's apartment. Entering her home was like going straight to Puerto Rico. Once a month at Abuelita's, my mom and my aunts would make sofrito, a spicy sauce. As they chopped peppers, onions, and tomatoes, I'd sneak to eat them right out of the blender.
Sonia, what have you done now?
Te vas a enfermar. You'll get sick. You can't eat it raw. The grown-ups played lots of music, and games too, like dominoes.
¿Tú estás ciego? It's right in front of your eyes.
One of my favorite moments was when everyone would go quiet and my abuelita would perform for us. She looked so glamorous. We'd all be mesmerized as she read one of her favorite Puerto Rican poems by José Gautier Benítez.
Para poder conocerla, es preciso comprarla, de lejos en sueños verla. Y para saber quererla, es necesario dejarla. To know it, you need to see it in dreams from afar. To learn how to love it, you need to live it.
I understood what the poem meant. I had so many dreams. When I was little, I used to imagine myself as the hero of my favorite book series, Nancy Drew, Girl Detective. Nancy was a master at doing puzzles, and no matter what got in her way, she could figure things out. She lived in a big house and solved crimes with her dad. Since he was a lawyer, he'd give her the best hints. I can't wait to be a detective when I grow up. In my neighborhood, dreams like that rarely came true. There weren't any detectives who looked like me. This is where I grew up. It's the Bronx, a neighborhood in New York City. Pretty different from Nancy Drew, huh? We didn't live in a fancy house. We lived in a small apartment. My mother was a nurse, so I knew some Puerto Rican nurses, but there was only one Puerto Rican doctor. At the stores where we shopped, there were a lot of Puerto Rican workers, but few managers or owners, and even fewer lawyers and detectives. It wasn't that my Puerto Rican neighbors didn't work hard. People aren't poor because they're lazy. My mother worked long hours to pay our bills, but sometimes where you live affects the kind of opportunities you have. If you live in a nice neighborhood like Nancy Drew, you can go to a school like this.
That looks nice and safe.
But if you live in a neighborhood like mine, you get a school that has fewer supplies and isn't as safe.
That definitely isn't nice.
Welcome to the Bronx. My mom worked extra hours so she could pay to send my brother and me to a more respected school.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.